Today, I have the pleasure of doing what I think is one of the most exciting interviews we've ever done on Investor Intel, which is to congratulate Energy Fuels and Neo Performance on basically altering the landscape for a rare earth supply chain with your announcement today. So how about we start with Constantine? What does this news release actually mean?
Well, it's apart from the fact that it is an exciting release, I think it says two things. First, this is, again, the reestablishment in a very long time of a supply chain that starts in the United States and joins with Europe to produce rare earths and value-added material. On the other hand, I think specifically for the two companies, I think it's a confirmation that both Energy Fuels and NEO, we do what we said we were going to do. I mean, it's you know, for us, it's not terribly exciting because it's there was never any doubt in my mind, or I believe Mark's mind. But you know, there's an awful lot of talk in the industry. And here we go. There's commercial quantities of rare earths mined in the United States, processed in Utah, and then shipped to Estonia for further processing. I think it's an exciting time, and it's a great development for both Energy Fuels and NEO.
So for all of you out there in Investor Intel land, you may be new to the rare earth industry, what we have is basically Energy Fuels and NEO Performance announced a contract signing today and the launch of commercial shipments of rare earth products to Europe. So Mark, on that note, it was just a short while ago when you said, you know, hey, not only do we supply uranium for nuclear energy here in the United States, but we're going to help with sustainability issues for the rest of the world with rare earths. And so tell us what this means to Energy Fuels, please.
Well, Tracy, as you know, I mean, we've been focused on what we call a critical mineral hub at White Mesa in southern Utah. And, you know, echoing what Constantine says, you know, I think one of the things, the attributes of both our companies is we're doers, not talkers, when it comes to making promises we can't keep. So, you know, I think, you know, when you look at the short period of time that, you know, we've announced that we were entering into the rare earth business and the time that we've been working together with NEO, you know, I think, I hope, and I think that the world is becoming surprised at the quick progress and the focus and the strategy, particularly on the monazite plan. You know, I think the monazite plan for monazite sands processing and perhaps other sources in time is a real winner. And so, you know, the relationship with us and NEO together, you know, help keep us focused in the early days of our development in this area.
Well, for those of us who've been following this industry since 2008, this seems like a really, really big deal. So was there a ribbon cutting or a shovel with a big bow on it, some champagne? Mark, what did you have over in Utah when this happened?
Well, I think we had a handshake and some Subway sandwiches. So, but no, we got photos of the event. It was a great event, having a representation from NEO and our employees at the mill were excited about the accomplishment and the progress being made. So yeah, it was a celebration. We didn't technically cut a ribbon, but yeah, it was, you know, we did have dinner afterwards and some nice wine. So what else is, you know, doesn't get much better than that.
Well, okay. So let's get right into it then. The announcement was that you have announced the first container of approximately 20 tons of product of an expected 15 containers of mixed rare earth carbonate. Now, this is where I'm going to throw the ball over to you, Constantine. Actually, NEO Performance, your Estonia plant has been producing rare earth carbonate now for what, 50 years? Is that correct?
No, it has been buying rare earth carbonate, primarily from Russia, from our suppliers at Solikamsk Magnesium Works, who are completely tapped out and they cannot supply anymore. So as we're trying to utilize available capacity and expand that capacity, this, you know, the project with Energy Fuels was extremely timely. And that will allow us to capture that available 25% or so capacity in our plant and push it a little further beyond nameplate 100% capacity. So it's clearly the right thing for NEO, and obviously I think it's the right thing for Energy Fuels.
And so what kind of commitment do you have with Energy Fuels to increase your supply? I mean, is it going to be exclusive? You know, you comment a little bit about this in your news release. Can you tell us more about this?
Sure. The definitive agreement, the supply and purchase agreement that we've signed says that there's a commitment for a certain volume of rare earth carbonate, which we have committed on both sides. And then any additional amounts of rare earth carbonate, there's a mutual obligation to offer it to us first, or, you know, there's a sort of a ROFR on both sides. So we could have additional materials as we're ramping up and we need them, and we have every intention to taking those materials. So the first phase of our relationship here with Energy Fuels is for Energy Fuels to produce really more rare earth carbonate that we would immediately need. But by the time those volumes become available, I expect that we have expanded the existing capacity at Silmet, so we'll be able to absorb pretty well everything that Energy Fuels produces.
And of course, we know relationships are very important to both of you, or at least I'm aware of this, having followed both of you for some time. Mark, I'm going to get back to you here. Your quote was fantastic. Your goals are very impressive. It says Energy Fuels has a goal of processing 15,000 tons of monazite or more per year in the future. This is 20 tons. So can you talk to us about what you deem scale to be and what your timeline is for achieving that scale?
Well, look, as I've said this, we're not looking at a small splash, we're looking at a big splash. And, you know, when it comes to the ability to process rare earth monazite sands and rare earth carbonate, we can ramp up very quickly given adequate feeds because of the size of the mill and the ability to handle that. But at the same time, you know, working closely with NEO in the long term, you know, we are also planning on, you know, having separation capacity at the White Mesa Mill, because we think that makes a lot of sense. And, you know, we're not really process limited when it comes to processing monazite sands at the mill. It's really just securing enough sources of monazite sands. I tell people, we're talking to pretty much everybody that makes monazite sands in the world, and they want to see an outlet, you know, going through the United States for processing and having the ability to distribute those finished materials in the United States and in Europe. So, you know, there's a lot of people cheering us on. So, you know, our plans are grand, and Constantine can verify when you look at the size of our tanks and the process facilities at White Mesa, and you look at the you know, small tonnages basically related to the monazite sands, you know, we've got a lot of capacity.
Well, of course, Constantine, you came out of retirement, in my opinion, to put this deal together. This, of course, is my opinion. You did come out of retirement to make some very large goals occur. Can you tell us how you kind of expect the market to respond to this substantial news?
Well, guilty as charged. I was retired, or I was non-executive chair of NEO, and I came back. And actually, Mark and I started working on this when I was still retired, but I'm very excited about this. So it continues to confirm that my decision to come out of retirement was the right one. So the market, you know, I expect that the market will see this as a positive. I also expect that it will see it as confirmation that we do what we say, and as Mark put it, we do. We just don't talk about it only. On the other hand, excuse me, on the other hand, I think there may be an inclination to see some of the comments in the press release about energy fuels going downstream into separation and further downstream as a potential conflict between NEO and energy fuels. This is completely not true. For those in the market that understand NEO, we operate three rare earth separation plants, two in China, one in Europe, the only one in Europe, if I may add. But our rare earth refining and separation business is really designed to feed our downstream high margin businesses in specialty rare earth materials for catalytic and electronic applications, as well as our magnetic business, which is where we make the bulk of our margins. So we are net buyers of separated rare earths in addition to rare earth raw materials. So to the extent that energy fuels can proceed along this business plan and establish large-scale rare earth separation in the United States, we'll be partners with them. We'll help them put it together, and we will, I expect that we will have agreements to buy the output from those from that larger scale separation plan. So we're very much aligned on this. Second, I wanted to vouch for what Mark said. I mean, I was so impressed by the capabilities at the White Mesa Mill at Energy Fuels. Very motivated, extremely capable people that were very enthusiastic about doing this. And when you look around Energy Fuels, you see very, very large scale plants that when Mark talks about 15,000 tons a year of monazite, that would still represent a trickle compared to the available capacity. And, you know, we did see the cracked monazite solution of rare earths going into a tank, and it's a trickle going into a massive tank. So I'm absolutely certain that Energy Fuels can get there because it has the capabilities. But perhaps more importantly, there's an infrastructure around Energy Fuels that is unique in the United States, if not the world. The capabilities that they have to deal with naturally occurring radioactive materials and not only deal with them, but turn them into a profit center by selling uranium to the energy sector, I think is unique in the industry. And also they have the environmental systems to deal with all the issues that historically have plagued the processing of monazite around the world. So, you know, these 1,000-year tailings ponds that Energy Fuels has at White Mesa are unique in the industry, and they are absolutely right-sized and properly done in order to make sure that Energy Fuels has what it takes to deliver on a very large game-changing project in the United States.
Well, you have it there. The most disruptive news in the supply chain for rare earths for rest of the world that we've had in the last decade here today on Investor Intel. Thank you so much for joining us both today.
Thanks, Tracy. Good to see you, Mark.